when we shot the ball scene, I wanted the ball to feel lively and fun and full of energy.
In this movie, we build everything piece by piece.
I certainly wanted the ball to feel like the kind of event that all our audience would want to dress up and go to.
The main aim with the costumes was to be as colorful as possible.
Ken once said he wanted to build the most beautiful ballroom anyone could imagine, which I think is kind of what they've been doing.
When I saw the designs for it, I was so pleased because they had this fantastic fairy tale quality to them. And you just wanted to visit that world that is not like our world.
We are all going to Cinderella's Ball. Please have an excellent time. Thank you very much.
We're shooting the ball sequence and the 007 stage, which I get excited about because that's where they shoot James Bond, which I love. And it's huge, and I've seen its progress over since before I started shooting. They were already well into making this massive, massive set.
To be able to watch the transformation of the sets from little paper models to MDF ballrooms, then all the layers get put on top and a fairy tale is being formed around you.
Lots of gold, a marvelous pattern on the floor.
An inspiration, especially from the Baroque style, with a lot of decoration in gold and marble. And so I put all together and then move it like this. And this is what it's come out.
Great when you come to a set and you see as much detail as they've put into this production. Everything has been thought of right down to the finest detail.
The first time I walked onto the set, I was gobsmacked. I mean, I had to pick my jaw off the floor.
And guys, you should carry on down at your positions onto the dance floor roughly. Top can go now, sorry.
It took them an hour to lower all of the chandeliers and to light them all.
Our crew was at the end of very long ladders, lighting the candles one by one by one.
There's going to be 2,500 lit candles during the scene.
And then to see what Sandy did with the costumes, I felt like I was transported back in terms of cinema. And so that was a wonderful storybook world to enter.
Have it populated with crowd dressed in costumes that Sandy had created that you, on any other film, you'd be delighted to put a principal actor in, the lead actor in.
There are loads of extras down there, so that takes quite a lot of people to dress them in the morning so they're all ready in time. But prior to that, we've had hundreds of seamstresses making all those things.
Well, it started with the dress. They chose this one out for me and then worked on it from there, chose my gloves, shoes, and then moved on to my earrings and necklace. And then they went on to my hair and they put all these accessories in, the sparkly bits, and then they went on to makeup and built up the whole picture. It was a good 4 hours and about 4 people working on hair and makeup.
You're done.
Yay. All done.
Let me remove this.
Thank you very much.
It's always going to be hard when you have a huge amount of people to get ready. We have nearly 400 extras. We've got a large cast. We have 50 makeup artists working on the background, and we have, I think, another 50 hairdressers.
So makeup designer Naomi, Don and I worked very closely together, and right at the beginning we wanted to have different period flavours throughout. Because this is a fairy tale, you have a little more freedom to play with the centuries and with the looks.
There is a diverse mix of characters and looks because the idea was that this is a ball for everybody, young, old, poor, rich. And also we wanted to have an element of international flavour. So we've dressed princesses from around the world. So we have Chinese, Japanese, Indian, African, Russian. Everybody is there to get the prince's attention.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a vintage piece. It's from the archives.
It's quite sparkly.
Swarovski offered up the opportunity for us to borrow some of their very precious archive jewellery. We ended up with hundreds of pieces of archive jewellery for the ball.
You know, to come back to me at the end of the day, don't you, Lily?
Thank you.
Ladies, shuffle down this way. as extras, we see the background. We see the scaffolding, we see the paperwork and everything. But when you hit the set, that almost disappears. And you really feel as if you are in a grand ball, and it's an amazing feeling.
You have to go through step by step by step, bring in some extras, then bring in some more crowd, then bring in some dancers. Then suddenly there were 500 people in that ballroom, another 500 people to deal with the costumes and the hair and the makeup and everything, and we had to start.
And background action, and action.
We have this amazing staircase, which is where I see Cinderella for the first time at the ball, and I've been waiting and hoping she's going to come. And I see her at the top of this amazing staircase in this amazing dress. It is a stunning image, and her dress does twinkle.
The detail of the dress is unbelievable. Within the skirt, there's 10,000 Swarovski crystals. So it glitters and sparkles in the light. It really is every little girl's dream to put on a dress like that, and it doesn't let you down.
Today's the first day we did any dancing here in the ballroom, and it's pretty thrilling. We spent the last couple of days waiting for the ball. Everyone was really ready to dance today.
I wanted to make sure that I knew how to dance as well as I believed he would. And I think dancing is something that the prince really loves. I think he's quite a physical person, and so that was something that I'm working on every day. I've never danced before, so I have to try and make it look as if I know what I'm doing. I very much feel the prince is leading Cinderella through quite a complicated routine, so I try and learn to dance as well as I can to lead Cinderella through it.
I actually feel most in character whilst I'm doing the dance, because there's something to do with the lightness and the elegance, that's this lightness of touch. I get very swept away in it while I'm dancing.
And the story lends itself to that element of insecurity that comes with a new relationship. You kind of really like someone, but you don't quite know if they like you back, and it's something that's really exciting to play, and it's so brilliant to play with Lily.
He's so in the moment, and he's very easy to fall in love with.
When Richard and Lily began to dance, it made me just want to weep. You just don't see that. You don't see those grand, romantic moments where you say, yes! And there's a couple of beautiful, really difficult lifts. And everyone just erupted into applause naturally when it happened, because it was so beautiful. And I think because you're really genuinely rooting for her.
Once they've danced and the whole room has watched them and been captivated by the two of them and by how they're feeling for each other, everyone sweeps onto the floor to dance as well. And we call that the champagne waltz.
Both dances in a row, really unfit. And I'm in this corset, so it's really hard to breathe. And it's so big and long, as you can see. So I think I just fell in love with Richard.
I'm Howell Davis. I'm the conductor for Cinderella. We're all terribly excited to be here. We are actually all professional, real musicians playing on period instruments. We're playing two waltzes and then a polka, typical ballroom dances. Really great fun, lots of energy, and we just hoped to portray the excitement of a ball, of a terribly, terribly, you know, prestigious ball.
The polka is very fast and kind of frantic. We brought the costume department in to raise the hems on a lot of the dresses for us so that we could make the dance athletic and use this absolutely beautiful ballroom floor.
The dance is lovely, it's incredible actually. There are lifts in it.
They've got pretty strong dancers, so it's amazing.
Everyone looks so beautiful, and it's like the ballroom is the most magical thing you've ever seen.
It was hard because we didn't rehearse in our big dresses or anything, so, but it was so cool and really fun to work with the dancers. They were amazing.
It's kind of film that you imagine doing when you're a kid and you want to get involved in the movies. And then you get onto a set like this and it's like all your dreams is rolled into one, you know? It's great.
It was really one of the most magical days I've ever had making movies. And it really felt as though everybody was enjoying the ball and enjoying. It was a wonderful day of creating in a film studio.